Oh, dude, listen, and welcome back. It's Yorkshire Blazeman here, and today I have another review for you. This is of this Spanish model 1941 bayonet. It's quite a unique bayonet because it's quite cool due to the fact it's a bolo blade bayonet used for the 8mm model 1943 Mauser short rifle. Now, this bayonet was this bayonet replaced the model 1871-90/93 socket bayonet for the model 1893 Mauser rifle. And it's interesting the fact that the Spanish went from a sword bayonet, the model 1913 for the model 1916 short Mauser short rifle, to a socket bayonet, and then to this bolo bayonet. Now, this bolo bayonet, the model 1941, was inspired by the Spanish artillery sword, which was basically a bolo blade and with a curved handle. So it took a lot of inspiration from there. There are a lot of misconceptions about this bayonet. Many people believe, and people sell it off, that these bayonets were used by the Spanish forces that fought for the Germans in Russia. They some commando unit, I've forgotten their name. But no, the Green Berets, not the Green Berets, but there was a fascist Spanish regiment that fought with the Germans in Russia, and people claim that these bayonets were used by them. They weren't. These were used by the standard Spanish military, and probably haven't really seen service, because Spain wasn't really in the conflict, and they were neutral during World War II to avoid dragging Portugal to join with the Allies. So before I show you this very lovely bayonet, it's not in the best of condition, unfortunately, which I will go over in the meanwhile. I'm just going to go over some facts and figures, and then we shall go into the main bayonet itself. So as I said, this is for the 8mm model 1943 Mauser short rifle. Designed as a replacement for the model 1917 artillery bolo knife. The model 1941, this bayonet here, retains the model 1907 blade's profile and heavy crosspiece for cutting vegetation. Just here, the crosspiece. It is known, in my best Spanish accent, as the Machete Bayoneta Modelo. So basically means the machete model bayonet. That's it. Nothing fancy, just straight to the point. These short bolo bayonets were very inefficient in cutting implements and were hated by those who used them. They're more of a chopping thing, you can't really cut from the as it's like a sort of like a cookery, you've got a heavy forward blade, so it's very hard to cut, but excellent for chopping. They were produced at the Fabrica de Armas de Toledo, which is the Toledo Arms Factory in English, and they were standard issue bayonets that would fit on, as I said, the 1943 Mauser. However, these wouldn't fit on straight away. Unlike most bayonets, you take it, you slide it onto the rifle, and it connects. Unfortunately, that was not the case with these bayonets. You had to have a, I'm going to butcher this pronunciation, a Richeri adapter, which was pinned to the bayonet bar on the rifle. And sometimes you can find it actually on the bayonet itself. Unfortunately, I haven't got one, but I will show you. It just attached onto here to allow you to lock it onto the rifle itself and then have it hanging down. So, that's just the information. Let's go over the specs. I will go over the specs with the bayonet out so you all can see it. If you weren't, if you didn't know what a bolo blade looked like, that's a bolo. Many people think, when I shove in this bayonet, that it's had this bit just like cut off, or it's been damaged or cut away. No, that's how it meant to look. A slight curve to it, and then it straightens out again, giving it a very forward, heavy feel. There's the frame, which is good. So, the specs. Blade length is 9.6 inches or 24.4 centimetres. The overall length from top to bottom is 14.3 inches or 36.5 centimetres. And the muzzle ring diameter is quite small on this. It's only 1.5 centimetres or 0.615 inches. Can you see that? And also in this, it's quite, the muzzle ring is up a lot. If you can see here, you know, it's quite a step up. It's about maybe 1.5 centimetres step up. To that compared to other bayonets, which the muzzle ring is just directly just above, well, above the handle, rather than having a chunk of metal above it. So, these bayonets were used during World War II period. Of course, as I said, Spain weren't in World War II, so it probably hasn't seen much action, but it might be seen action in the colony, well, in colony wars in Spain, or during people can get hold of them and use them. I don't know, but it has been a lot of wear and tear on the blade, which I'll go over in just a minute. If it suggests that someone has very poorly tried to sharpen this and has wrecked the blade, or it's just war action, but I think someone's just not looked after it. So my bayonet is matching. We have the issue number just above the cross piece here, which is 5063G. Done to on the Ocaso. The Ocaso shows that. Many people don't know, but this part above the cross piece here, we have the Ocaso, which is this bit, and then you have the blade. The Ocaso normally on bayonets is where there is no blade, it's just the metal, as you can see here. So that's just the Ocaso there. So 5063G. On the opposite side, we have the Toledo Fabrica, the Toledo arms badge. Unfortunately, it is worn down a bit, but that's all due with age. I will take a photo and zoom it in and show you. Handle is made from wood, a nice checkered wood, and it has seen, it is quite smooth. Some parts are worn down, so it's seen a lot of action. Hang on, I believe my camera lens is dirty. Let me just clean that. I was just looking through now, and I just realised it. I do apologise. Bear with. Let's just give that a wipe. Hey, that's much better. I'm really sorry about it, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not with it today. On the pommel, we have no marks, but we have the eagle's head. This is what it's called, and we have a push-button stud to release the bayonet from the rifle bar. It is quite a thin handle, this, judging by how aggressively heavy it is. If I just take a tape measure, I have put a tape measure somewhere. I can't seem to find it. Oh, it's over there. Bear with me. So if we take a tape measure, it is 1.5 centimetres wide there, and that biggest width of the handle is 2.2. So it is quite a small bayonet handle, to be honest with you. Normally some are quite thicker, especially the AK ones. We've got a blade thickness of 0.4 centimeters, and then it tapers down to 0.1 centimeters. On the cross piece itself, we have a U here. I'm not sure what that means. And we have a 6 and a moon, like a crescent moon shape, or a C here as well. I've noticed that on Portuguese ones have that crescent moon. I don't know what it is meant to resemble. I'm not sure. On the cross piece, the thickest part is 2.1 centimeters, and its height is just 0.9. As you can see, there has been a lot of edge damage. I'm not sure that someone's tried to sharpen it and they just wrecked it, but unfortunately it has damaged the bayonet. When I got it, there was a load of rust on it. I don't like restoring bayonets. If I'm buying a bayonet for myself, I won't restore it. If I'm sending it on, I will, but I won't make it in pristine condition. I just clean it up a bit, get rid of the rust and protect it. As you can see, there still is quite a bit of pitting on the blade. This cross piece and the pommel aren't glistening, which I don't really like. But if I show on the handle, there is a lot of handle on the scabbard, but there's still a lot of rust. And there's the look of that. Very comfortable in the hand after the middle. Really good chopper at this. So, on the scabbard. It rattles a bit. I think there's something inside there. If you can hear a button. I don't know if you can hear that. Which I'm not sure what it is. Maybe it's just a pin loose, I'm not sure. Anyway, that is weird. I've not noticed that. So, on the scabbard 5063G, you can see there, issue number, has a few dints in it, especially here. Quite a bit of rust pitting on there. I won't really give that off. I've used an abrasive brush, like a scouring pad, but I don't want to do that because it's going to take off the natural finish. On the scabbard top piece, I honestly don't know what this is called. We have C here. I will take a photo, and we have some cut up, some lines going down. I honestly don't know what this means. I would like to think it's, and on here as well, it's like to think it's definitely done by someone. So maybe it's how many people it's stabbed. I don't know. That's a cynical way of thinking about it, but I am not sure. The bayonet has a good solid fit in the scabbard. If I hold it upside down, it's not going to come out, but I know if I give it a good shake, it will come out. There is a bit of play in there. It's not, you know, it's such a snug fit, but there's no wobble, but there is a bit of wobble. But overall, it's a nice piece of Spanish history. It's not the best of conditions, but I think it's a nice piece to have because it's interesting. It's not a straight bayonet, it's not a knife bayonet, it's a bolo bayonet. You don't see many of those because they're not very good. But it's a nice piece of Spanish history. If you're looking to buy one of these, they cost around, but if in good condition, you can pick for one about £70, maybe 80. It all depends on where you buy them, but you can normally pick up one in this quality about £40-50 if you're not willing to spend a lot of money. A lot of people don't know what they are, but they see the Spanish thing and they say it's just a Spanish bayonet. But I've seen these in quite a few auctions and they don't go for crazy money. If you like collecting Spanish history, or you like collecting interesting bayonets, or just like collecting sword bayonets, it's a perfect one for you. So, thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a big thumbs up, give it a like. And being more interested in that, subscribe to my channel, because it will really help me grow. I have been your one and only host for Yorkshire Bladesman, and I shall see you next time. Goodbye.